Ah, very good.
Amazing.
So I'm warm in my stomach, you know.
I don't know, it tastes like coffee to me.
We're here to talk about the language of coffee. We do test coffee at Consumer Reports, and we're here at Gregory's Coffee with Gregory. We probably speak the same language, but consumers can get awfully confused with some of the terminology. So maybe we can talk a little bit about the coffee terms and what they mean.
So here we have a little cupping setup. This is a great way to kind of evaluate a coffee in its purest sense. We take our spoon, and pardon me, but this is not the most glamorous way of tasting coffee, but it is a really necessary to do it. So what I'll do is I'll dip my spoon in the cupping bowl and slurp it back. The reason why I'm slurping like that is I want to coat my entire tongue with the coffee. So it's very similar to like tasting wine, where you know, you're getting notes and flavors in these coffees that are kind of natural. There's nothing added to them. But when we taste these coffees, we look for multiple layers, balance. That's what makes these coffees special. So what did you think of this coffee?
It's like a lighter body, right?
Yes.
Not too heavy.
This is like a lighter roasted coffee.
You get a little sweetness.
I get a nice sweetness, like we say, like I get a little bit of like a toffee, almost caramelly too. But then I definitely get some brightness there. Maybe a little bit of lemon. So it's nice to see those two play together, and it's really balanced on my tongue. So to me, this coffee has this really nice grapefruit quality.
Yeah.
Which is funny, because not everybody loves grapefruit. It's kind of like got that tart, tartness to it. People think of acid and they think of bad, right?
Right.
But acidity in coffee is actually a pleasurable thing that's desirable. So if you bite into an orange, you don't think about it, but that's citric acid. You know, that's what you're tasting, and it's pleasurable.
I thought I tasted a little cherry, but.
Yeah, no, that's when we're on the cupping table, anything's there. We get Fruit Loops, I get, you know, hot sauce, I get crazy things that people think they smell, but all that matters is what do you taste and things that you're getting out of these coffees.
It's amazing. I mean, one bean can spoil the whole brew, right?
Yes, so there's things called like a defect, like potato defect, where all it takes is literally like one bean in the bag. And when you're brewing a coffee, it'll just, you know, make the whole thing taste really, really funky, like rotten potato almost. So it is really important to make sure that, you know, we are testing these and make sure we can pick out defects if they exist.
So now you can sound a little bit more informed when you have that coffee with your friends.